Hello guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to a brand new tutorial video. And today's video is going to be of my version of Bloodstream by Ed Sheeran, which I released last week. And I know a lot of you have been waiting all week for this video, so I'm going to get stuck straight in. And the first thing that you should be doing is putting the capo on the first fret, as you can see. It's on the first fret of the guitar there. And other than that, the guitar's in standard tuning. And the most important part to get right at first, as with any loop song, is the first loop. So that first riff, once you get that in time and recorded and playing, then the rest of the loops are just going to follow that and everything will sound good. And I know a lot of you are a bit scared about this riff because it's finger picky and it's a bit fast, and you probably don't want to hear this, but it really is just repetition. To get that right is just keep doing it. Start off slow and build up your pace as you get more confident with it. So I'm going to get straight in and show you how to play that first riff. And the first chord of that riff is with your first finger on the fifth fret in relation to the capo. So that's actually the sixth fret of the guitar because the capo is on the first fret. So fifth fret in relation to the capo on the A string. And then your third finger you want on the seventh fret in relation to the capo on the D string. And then the G string is going to be open. And the finger picking pattern is played with your thumb, first finger and second finger. So the first three notes of the first chord should sound like that. And the finger picking pattern itself goes thumb, first finger, second finger, thumb, first finger, second finger, thumb, first finger. And that's played twice for each chord. So the first chord should sound so, as I said, thumb, first finger, second finger, thumb, first finger, second finger, thumb, first finger, thumb, first finger, second finger, thumb, first finger, second finger, thumb, first finger. So, as I said, that's the first chord. And the second chord is literally just that moved down to the first fret. Actually, the second fret, but the first fret in relation to the capo. So, down here. What you might notice about that is that the finger picking pattern is exactly the same for the second chord as it is for the first chord. So the first two together should sound like. And the third of the chords is literally played by putting the second finger on the third fret. To replace what the first finger's doing, third fret on the A string, so. And, yep, you've guessed it, it's exactly the same finger picking pattern again. The only time that the finger picking pattern changes is for the fourth and final chord of that first riff, which is where the second finger moves over to the E string. So bottom E string, again on the third fret, so it's literally moving from one string to the next on the same fret. And the finger picking pattern remains the same, but the thumb is playing the E string, not the A string. So the final chord is played like this. So the whole riff altogether should sound like. And that's the point at which you hit that loop button, the record button, to play it over. My apologies, by the way, let me interrupt, about the noise that this guitar strap makes when I move around. It's the leather on the end creaking. And it's really quite annoying. It started to get really annoying at gigs as well, so I'm going to have to replace the strap to get one that's not got those leather bits on. Really irritating, so apologies about that. When you've looped that first riff, it's quite straightforward from that point on, for a bit at least. The next part is changing over to the second channel of the loop station and adding that loop, the vocal loop there. And that's, as I say, that's done on channel two because we want to drop that out in the verses. So we're going to be playing the riff into channel one, flicking over to channel two, adding those vocal melodies. During the second one of those, which is actually just the first one repeated, we add some power chords in as well. So I'll show you how to play those now so that I can do the, all of the first bit of looping without having to stop and go through chords and things. During the second of the looped vocals, or whatever you want to call it, the bit that I just said about, I grab my pick out of the mic stand here, and I'm just playing those chords of the riff just as power chords. So we've got the first finger on the fifth fret of the A string, third finger on the seventh fret of the D string, and the fourth finger, the pinky, on the seventh fret of the G string. So first chord. Then move it all down to the first fret as we did before. Then we're moving it all up to the third fret. We're not just moving that one finger up, we're moving the whole thing up. And then again, moving everything up a string, kind of like we did in the riff. So first finger on the third fret of the E string, third finger on the fifth fret of the A string, and the fourth finger, the pinky, on the fifth fret of the D string. Something like that. So yeah, all of those chords together should sound. And as I said, that's looped with the second of the vocal loops. But be careful not to overplay that, because you don't want to drown out the riff, because the riff's quite an important part of the song. So I'm going to just put those loops into the loop station, but I'm going to do them slowly so that you can really hear how they go. If you want to hear this at full speed, and it, also if you haven't heard my version of this, you've not seen my cover video for this, check out the link here. I'll add it there in that corner, just so that you can see it. If you want to see it full speed, just watch it there. I'm not going to do it full speed on this video, because this is obviously to learn how to play it. So I'm going to stick my headphones on so that I can hear what the loop station's doing. I'm going to dive straight in and add that riff again that we've just gone through. So I'm going to wait for that truck to go past and all the traffic that's behind it. Unfortunately, I live next to a main road, so that's why there's so much road noise in these videos. But hopefully at some point I'll be able to soundproof a little bit better. But anyway, I'm rambling again. As I said, the riff I'm going to add in slowly, so it should sound something like this. As I said, we've flicked over to channel two now, ready to add those vocal melodies into this mic here. So that's literally all of the looping for the first little section before the verse comes in. And then there's a tricky little bit of footwork as that comes in, because what we've got to do all at the same time, don't forget we're recording into channel two there, and we want to stop channel two because those vocal melodies need to stop before the lead vocal comes in. And what we also need to do, other than just stop that, we need to then flick back over to channel one to hit record again, ready for the bass drummy sound like that. So with both of these tracks playing, obviously we'd be over in channel two, the footwork should look something like this. Stop, change, and recording, ready for that section. So hopefully you'll have kind of got how that could be a little bit sort of difficult to do. It took me a couple of tries to get it right in the video. So, yeah, again, I'll go straight in to show you that it is possible to do. Stop, change. I've been spinning out for time. Couple women by my side. I got sinning on my mind. Sipping on red wine. I've been sitting here for ages. Ripping up the pages. How'd I get so faded? How'd I get so faded? Oh no, no, don't leave me lonely now. If you love me, how you never love. Oh, color crimson in my eyes. Wanna take a frame of mind. And then at this point, we're stopping everything because the next bit is played without any loops whatsoever. So you've heard that bit, how the sort of verse goes. So from that point there. Straight in, just straight forward on the stop button, ready for the. This is how it ends. I feel the chemicals burning my bloodstream. So that the chords for that part are those power chord shapes again, on the A string, first fret, up two frets to the third, up two frets again to the fifth, and then back down to the first, up to the third, and then back down to the E string on that third fret. So, and then it's just that whole thing played over again. So you should be able to see how straightforward that is.
I feel the chemicals burning my bloodstream.
The other sort of difficult bit about that is during playing that section, we need to be back on the loop pedal, changing the channel, not once but twice, because we need to change over to channel 2 and then press and hold again. If you're not using the FS5U, I am using the FS5U to change the channel, so press that again to arm both tracks. So both of those tracks should be armed, ready to come in for the chorus, ready for the.
Faded out again. I feel the chemicals burning my bloodstream. Tell me when it kicks in. So tell me when it kicks in.
During this part, we need to change back over to channel 2 because we need to drop channel 2 out here, ready for the next verse. So, straight back in and vocals again through that second verse and the second part of the verse, and then the pre-chorus again where everything drops out. So that section is exactly the same as the first verse and pre-chorus bit, and the chorus for that matter. And then the only bit where it changes after that is after the second chorus. So we're going to go from there. Sorry if I'm jumping on too quickly, but it is quite straightforward. That second part is just the same over again, just with different lyrics. So imagining that this now is chorus number 2.
Tell me when it kicks in.
Then we need to press the stop button twice in quick succession here to stop both. Ready for.
All the voices in my mind calling out across the line.
So what I did there was press the stop button twice to stop both the channels at the same time, because the song changes completely at that point. And the chords for that, again, we're back on those power chord shapes. Really, really straightforward guitar work here. first fret for all the third fret to the fifth fret, and it's just that repeated. And then as we're playing that and singing into this microphone, we need to be changing the tracks back to arm, both tracks ready to wipe everything that's in both channels of the loop station. So
all the voices in my mind calling out across the line, all the voices in my mind calling,
and then over to this microphone ready to come in with what I was just playing looped over. So I'm going to do that now.
All the voices in my mind calling out across the line, all the voices in my mind calling out across the line, all the voices in my mind calling out across.
So again, really straightforward. The next loop we're going to be doing is that vocal line without the guitar, just repeated, so.
All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind calling out across the line. All the voices in my mind.
So as you can hear, that's quite straightforward. It's just building those vocal melodies up. So the first one was all the voices in my mind calling out across the line, and then we're going up to all the voices in my mind calling out across the line, and then up to all the voices in my mind. No, there was one in between. There was one in between that goes all the voices in my mind calling out across the line, and then the last one is all the voices in my mind, that high one. So all together they sound like that. And then the next thing that I do is just adding that beat back in. I can't remember exactly how I played it there, but again, bass drum sound is down at the bridge there with the pick for a snare drum sound. Quite straightforward. So adding those in should sound quite straightforward again. And then the next section that I'm adding is that other vocal line. I saw scars upon her, tell me when it kicks in, broken hearted. I add that into this mic just so that it's going and going and going. So I'm going to add that now.
All the voices in my mind calling out.
I saw scars upon her, tell me when it kicks in,
calling out
broken hearted. Tell me when it kicks in.
And then at that point I start to add those more bass drum lines and just noise really. When Ed does that, he goes absolutely mental. Obviously I try to refrain a little bit, because pretty much because Ed gets Martin guitars given to him, don't forget. I don't want to break my Taylor, so I sort of keep it on the low down a little bit, or the down low, whichever way you want to say that. But the bit that I add is literally just hitting there and then a bit of that. So I'm going to add that in now.
All the voices
It is actually quite hard to do that at that speed, but you get the idea. And then after that is where I start to do that, the vocal part. Tell me when it kicks in! Or whatever the note was there. It's quite difficult to do that without actually being mid-song as well. But and yeah, that's done just 4 or 5 times, I think. And then I stop the loop as I do the last one. It sounds quite cool to add that, belt that vocal out with nothing else. Sounds quite cool, so. Tell me when it kicks in!
I saw scars upon her, tell me when it kicks in. Broken hearted, tell me when it kicks in. I saw scars upon her, tell me when it kicks in. Broken hearted.
So that's literally just those chords again, from 1st fret to 3rd fret to 5th fret there at the end to finish the song off. And that literally is, that's it, really. I say that's it. It is one of the sort of more challenging loop songs that I do, but particularly because of that riff at the beginning. If you snuff that riff up at the beginning, then you end up having to restart the song, which looks really unprofessional. I've had to do that a couple of times as well. But for the most part, because I've played it a few more times now, I'm sort of getting used to playing the riff. So as I said, it's just the repetition thing going on. So I hope that was helpful to you guys, and yeah, as I always say, if you've got any questions, if I've not explained anything properly, please let me know in the comments section below this video. I really love to hear from you guys anyway, and it's really lovely to hear that my videos are helping people out and people are finding value in what I do and stuff. So as always, thanks for watching, thanks for being here. If you've liked the video, you can give it a thumbs up down below one of these sides somewhere. And if you like what I do, please consider subscribing as well, because it does help. I can find out how many people I'm making my videos for and stuff, and you can get alerts when I upload new stuff. So yeah, like, comment and subscribe and all that. As I always say, you can follow me on Twitter at @TweedNelson as well, for random stuff that I post on there, and you can ask me questions on there as well if you want. But yeah, as I said, thanks for watching. It really is lovely to hear from you guys and know that what I do is helping out and stuff like that. So yeah, that's all for now. Until next time, take care, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.